So good morning, gang. I'm glad you've tuned in today because, hey, I've got a very important announcement to make and important information to share and an explanation to give. So hopefully you'll stay tuned in because I think this is important, or it would be important to a lot of us. As of today, we are no longer going to be sharing our Searchlight stuff on this particular platform. We are going to be airing our videos, teaching videos, the 2,500 plus videos of our Thru-the-Bible studies and sermons, and also postcards and text messages and all of the things that we've been doing here on this platform are now going to be available on, posted on, our Searchlight at johncourson.com. So just go to johncourson.com or to our Searchlight website. Searchlight website, johncourson.com, and that's where all of our content and material and teachings and postcards and all the rest will be available for you. Now, you may say, why are you doing that? And here's where I want to give an explanation. For some time, for quite a long time, I've been extremely concerned about what social media is doing to our culture, and yes, to the church and to Christians too. I have really been wondering about and praying about what I might be able to do to help be part of the solution instead of part of that particular problem. Now, personally, I've never personally been on Facebook, not even once, or TikTok, or Instagram, nope, or Snapchat, or any of those platforms. I've never gone there, but I've seen what they have done to so many people. The screen can become addictive on those kinds of platforms to people and can cause people to be sucked into misinformation and divisive materials and anger and frustrations and catastrophizing and a mean-spiritedness and all of the things which to me are so very contrary to what the Word tells me and you that we're to be thinking on. Things that are true and lovely and just and pure. If there's virtue and praise, think on these things, you see. To set our hearts on things above. And things that we think through and think about ought to be framed by and permeated with love. Loving God and loving people, not competing against people or comparing ourselves with people or coming down on people. That is all too often the case with posts, with things that are taking place there on those social media sites. So I've never gone there myself, but I've seen what it's done. People getting addicted to those sites and things and social media, and then getting angry with these guys or down on that group, or people just telling plain old flat out lies about these folks or that group or whatever it might be. And it spreads like wildfire. And just things that are unkind. Even if they might be true, they're just not kind. So I've been, like so many of you, have been concerned about this, what it's doing to our culture and what it's doing to Christians and to churches, to individual people. So we've only been on one platform, and that is this one. But even this one has been problematic because, well, they started running advertisements on our videos, on our teachings, and all the rest. We never asked for that. And by the way, we never took a penny from that. But those things were done. We had no choice in the matter or no say about that. It was just done. And then, of course, they would give suggestions of videos to watch. And these suggestions were oftentimes, as I looked on them and looked at them, checking out our Searchlight channel, I found that these suggestions were just feeding a thing, a part of people that I don't think needs to be fed, if you would. So I've been concerned for some time about that, but not knowing what the alternative could be, seeing as how we had so much material, wanting to make it available for everybody. We found a way to do it, to avoid all of the stuff I'm talking about, the suggested videos that are flashed on our site. And some of them are fine, but a lot of them I would say, no, don't go there. Don't take that in. So much of what's done is clickbait and trying to be controversial or edgy or inflammatory or whatever it might be. I just don't like it personally. So we found a way now, starting today, to have all of our material available without any of those things. You just go to our website, and it's all there, available for you, available to you, anytime you want to tap in or grab a hold of the Thru-the-Bible studies or recent postcards or future teachings I'll be giving, whatever it might be. Oh, by the way, not only have I not ever personally got involved with the Instagram, TikTok, I don't even have a cell phone. I got rid of my cell phone some time ago. So, you know, if you've tried to call me on my cell phone and just got voicemail, that's been corrected. But that had been going, I guess, for months and months and months and months. I never got those voicemail messages. I never got text messages. I'm just kind of, I have a rotary telephone, a retro rotary, which the cool thing about that, amongst other things, is when the phone rings in here, as I'm sitting here, the phone rings, I never know who it is. So I just pick up every single call. I don't say, oh, I'll get back to him or back to her or back to them later. I'll let it go to voicemail. It doesn't have voicemail, and I don't know who it might be. So I just make it a point to pick up every call that comes in. And it's just so wonderful, so simple for me. But I don't have email, and I don't have text messaging, and I don't have all of those kinds of things that I know can be so helpful to people and are helpful to people. But for me, I found it to be so freeing to simplify, simplify, simplify. So all that's to say, if you wrote me an email, or if you sent me a text message, or if you left me a voicemail in the past year or two or whatever it's been, hey, I never got it. So that's why there was no response. If you called me on my telephone, or you wrote me a letter, or you sent a note via the Searchlight website, my friend and colleague and blessed brother Bob, who runs our whole Searchlight thing, you know, he takes those and passes them on to me. And so here's the thing, gang. Here's what I want you to see, is that I have found at this point in my life to live a quieter life, as quiet as possible, away from the screamings and yellings of platforms and websites and all those kinds of things. And I have found it to be oh so beneficial. Now, you might say, but John, those things are used by the Lord to get the word out, and these ministries and those ministries and these folks and those guys are effectively getting the word out. I know, and more power to them. God bless them. I'm grateful for them, like Paul the Apostle. Paul the Apostle used every bit of technology, cutting-edge technology, every means of technology to get out his message, to get out the gospel. What do you mean technology? Well, he had an amanuensis, which is a guy that would write like a secretary taking shorthand, a guy that would write for him so that he could send out letters even while he was in prison, or when his eyes were not good, or when he had other things he was doing. He had that technology. That was the cutting-edge technology of the day. An amanuensis, a secretary, we might say today. He used ships to get as far as he could to get the gospel out to the farthest regions possible. He would use ships, cutting-edge technology as far as travel goes. He would use his political Roman citizenship when he was brought into judicial cases and matters. He would play that card, use that Roman citizenship politically. He used the postal system of the day, which was the cutting edge technology on the Roman roads that greatly furthered the ability to get letters out, epistles out. What I'm getting at, I could go on and on, is that Paul, Brother Paul, he used every bit of technology available to get the word out, to see the gospel go as far as it could and reach as many people as it may, as it might, as it could. That was his heart. And I love that. But I also love the example of Jesus. and that's more in harmony with my heart. Now, Jesus and Paul both obviously appointed, anointed, empowered, directed. But Jesus had a different technique. He didn't use the technology of the day. What I mean by that is this. He never wrote a single epistle or letter. In those years, as he was in Galilee and around and in Jerusalem, in his ministry, he never wrote a thing. Well, the one time he wrote was he wrote in the dust there at the temple when the woman was caught in adultery. The only mention that we have, the only allusion that we have of Jesus writing, and we don't even know what he wrote. Oh, I've speculated, and we can surmise, guess, and speculate, but we don't know what he wrote. Whereas Paul, my goodness, he was always writing, and we know what he wrote, thank the Lord. But Jesus, he didn't get involved in writing. He didn't travel. He stayed there in Israel. And he said, we're staying here, to his boys. We're staying here in the land to minister to the lost sheep of Israel, you see. And my, oh my, when he would do a miracle, he didn't say, post it on Instagram. He would say over and over again, don't tell anybody. And when they wanted to make him king, when he was getting tremendous reviews and lots of likes or lots of followers or whatever it might be, he said, no. When they said, we want to make you king, he departed from them immediately and went out into a solitary place, to a quiet place. He left that hubbub and that fame, if you would. In fact, the only time that Jesus ever got involved in media, if you would, in that kind of way, was when he orchestrated the entry, the triumphant entry, the triumphal entry into Jerusalem. But the purpose of that, the reason for that, was that it would ultimately, in that week, lead to his trial and execution. The purpose wasn't for fame. The purpose was to bring about his death. He rode into the city and allowed there to be, you know, all of that hubbub taking place, orchestrated it actually for the purpose of his crucifixion. Amazing. But Jesus went about in such a way that even when he was betrayed, Judas had to identify him with a kiss. You know the story. Why? Because he chose to travel in a quieter way. I love that. Again, what I'm suggesting is to those that utilize the Paul model of using every technology, getting the word out, using every form of modern opportunities, good for you, I say. God bless you, and I mean that truly. But for those of us that say the Jesus way is more in line with what we're desiring, what we're craving, what we're wanting personally, and frankly, for our culture, that our culture would just calm down and be, even as the Word of God says, students of quietness to a greater degree. The Word says to you and me, study or learn to be quiet. I like that. And there's so much noise and shouting and finger pointing and accusation, and so much of that in social media is to get, again, views, to get clicks, to get followers, subscribers, whatever it might be, to drive that particular thing or person into greater visibility for reasons that can be not the best, you see. So again, I'm not denigrating. I'm just saying I much prefer and have discovered for me in my walk, the simpler I make it and the more I free myself from screen stuff and from media stuff. So I am so thrilled to say we're going to pull off the one platform that we have been on, and we're going to say, hey, we don't need even that anymore. We found another way, a better way to do it, where there's no people screaming at you or trying to get you to go to their site or their whatever it might be to bring about whatever they're so often trying to do. And just, hey, to have a place, an oasis of undistractedness. Again, go to our Searchlight website. Or johncourson.com, that'll get you there too, and you'll have all of the stuff available there, just there. People say, well, you know, John, the idea of this platform that you're on presently, or were on until this video announcement, you see, but there's a lot of good on it too. And again, I want to reiterate, I know that. But would you think about this as you ponder these things? This is my perspective. In the Garden of Eden, there was the tree of life. Mm-hmm. And there was another tree called the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. And the Lord said, Father said, eat of anything here in the garden. Every tree every fruit, everything is available to you and permissible for you, even the tree of life. But there's one tree I don't want you to eat from. It's the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Interesting. There's good and evil. And there at the bottom of that tree, personally, I hear, if I could put it this way, poetically, the hissing of the serpent, the snake, Satan. It's good, he said. It's good tasting. It's good looking. It's good in how it will inform you. You'll know more. You'll be like God, you see. God said, careful about that. Those that offer you good and evil. Well, I know there's evil there, and there's evil in this, or there's evil in that, but there's also good. Okay, but just be careful, be cautious, because in the Garden of Eden, I find it personally interesting that that was the tree that God said, don't go there where there's good and evil. Hey, stay with the tree of life, with the tree of love, with the tree of light. That's tremendous. The other tree might stump you. It might hurt us, you see. We might find ourselves just all of a sudden ashamed, as they were when they ate of that tree and were suddenly aware of their nakedness and felt ashamed, and all the rest, you know the story. So my prayer is that a lot of us might discover, move towards more and more, a simpler life, freer from the voices and seductions and accusations and arguments and divisions and putting people down and finding fault with this group and finding fault with those guys and arguing these points, just to put it all away. And just to, rather than get burdened, catastrophizing, angry, suspicious, and skeptical, and cynical, and critical, rather spend our days laughing. L-A-F-L, love. A, accept. F, forgive. L-A-F, loving, accepting, forgiving. Everybody, everywhere, of everything, every day. Jesus said, by this shall all men know that you are my disciples, by your love. Mm-hmm. So, social media platforms often are not conducive to that, but rather they mitigate against that. So for that reason, we're taking Searchlight off the one platform that we've been on, not knowing how to do it any other way because of the amounts of material that we have. And now we're just going to be on the website, the Searchlight website, johncourson.com, and you'll have everything available there, exclusively there. And also we'll do all of our continuing postcards and so forth and so on from there, and you'll find them on there. So that's the thing that I wanted to bring your way today. There's the announcement. We're going off this platform, and we're on no other platforms. And the information, but you can find us there at the Searchlight website. And the explanation, which hopefully not only explains why we've made this choice, I've made this choice to do this thing, but the reason behind it. I just don't want to take any of you Searchlighters, friends of Jesus, brothers and sisters to a place where you're going to be exposed to other things that are mean-spirited or trying to get you mad at or cynical about or critical of these guys or that group or whatever it may be. I want Searchlight to be a place of peace and oasis, to focus on Jesus, nothing more, nothing less, and nothing else. And as much as you're able to simplify your thing and stay away, certainly, from the continual draw of screens and addiction to screens, you're going to find yourself, I think, enjoying your walk with the Lord, laughing, L-A-F, a whole lot more, and experiencing a peace that maybe has been missing from your life in recent days due to the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Good stuff, yes, but evil things too. And hey, I think those things ought to be thought through by each of us, all of us. So you could very well disagree with my perspective, and that's fine. And like I say, you see Paul using every form of technology available in his day. But I also find, for me personally, I prefer the model of Jesus, who went out of his way to not be known, if you would, to not post his healings, if you would, to not make a lot of noise, if you would, to do it a different way. And I find that that just resonates with me. So, praise the Lord. The Lord uses different men in different ways, different women in different ways, different groups in different ways. But that's my perspective. That's my story. And I'm sticking to it. Thank you for taking the time, almost a half hour, to listen to this. And the Lord bless you in your walk with him. May he give you peace. And may he cause you to laugh your way, love, accept, and forgive everybody this day and every day. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen.